Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we're live again with you guys for the show Your Rehnumai. Today here with us today we have Maryam Arshad. She will be talking to you guys about professional communication. We are on the day 4 of our week for jobs and career, and the topic that we have chosen for today for you guys is professional communication. We started this week with how to choose your career. Then we went on to how to build your profile. Then when we went on with job hunting. Now you have in the story of this week you have your job now, and as you have gotten the letter, now you learn how, when you go into the job, how are you gonna professionally communicate. तो आम जिंदगी में तो आप पर्सनली कम्युनिकेट कर रहे होते हैं, बट प्रोफेशनल जिंदगी में प्रोफेशनल कम्युनिकेशन बहुत डिफरेंट होती है और उसके बहुत सारे डायनेमिक्स होते हैं. इसके लिए स्पेशल वर्कशॉप्स होती हैं जो कि मरियम नेशनल इनक्यूबेटर में क्रिएट भी करती हैं. दैट इज़ वाई वी हैव मरियम विद अस, बिकॉज शी सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल शी इज़ एन अमेजिंग एंटरप्रेन्योर. She has a startup called Impact Dynamics, which basically what it does is it creates curriculum for the national for incubation centers to help startups build their businesses. And she has been an international speaker at Silicon Valley, and she has also been at Google. Maryam, how do you say it? I'm forgetting it right now. Can you catch me up here?
Yeah, sure. I've spoken at Google headquarters, the Asia Pacific region.
Yeah. Thank you. So yeah, I was forgetting. Thank you, Maryam, for catching me up on here. So Maryam is an amazing speaker to talk on this topic of professional communication, because she herself designs workshops on for businesses over professional communications. So today we'll start our talk with by asking Maryam how she defines professional communication, like what are the dimensions of professional communication that she would like to define, ki kya kya uske dynamics hote hain. Ji Maryam, thank you
so much Rabir. I just want to have a feel of my audience. Is my audience more student based, or are they more startups or people running their own businesses or aspiring entrepreneurs?
So you just said it. They're all of those. So there are students, there are people who are just starting up their businesses, startups, and yeah. So students who wants to start, who wants to have a startup in the future as well. Yeah.
All right. Okay. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you for the very nice introduction, Rabir. When you talk about professional communication, and speaking of communication, right now I'm communicating with all of you. We're engaged in a conversation, be it one way, because we cannot hear you at this point in time. But professional communication, or communication for that matter, entails, you know, basically a sender and receiver. And that's a very, very conventional thing that you must have learned in universities and schools for that matter. But communication is a lot more than that. Whether you are selling snakes or you're baking cakes, you have to communicate, you have to sell your point across the board. Because if it is not sold rightly across the board, if you do not happen to be a good storyteller, your product or your service might not be asked for. A lot of brands might make brilliant products in the market. One of my favorite case studies, in fact, is when Microsoft launched its tablet back in 95, 96. And that is basically what you know as an iPad nowadays. And it was an absolute flop because it was not marketed properly in the market, right? It was not communicated. Down the road, that same idea was taken by Apple and then redone in a very nice way. And iPad is something we all are a fan of. I mean, it's in every house, every kid, every adult, every elderly person knows how to use an iPad. So it's the communication which actually consists of your story, aapki kahani. Agar main aapko ek bahut complicated words mein twist karke suna dun ya bata dun, that would make the entire process very are hard to understand, hard to comprehend. And if I communicate in the easiest of words without using technical language, that is jargon, it will be understood to your receiver, who is most likely your consumer or somebody who's selling your product or service to, for that matter. So communication is a key in building relationships. It's a key in building your personal brand for people who do not even want to start a business. It's also about your own personal brand. People who are going to step out in the job market, communication is all about working on your personal identity, personal profile, rightly putting yourself out there so that you are, you are appreciated, and your content or your personality or your outlook is so charismatic in such a positive way that, I mean, charisma is always positive for that matter, that people would like to engage with you in a conversation. This is what communication is. Professional communication, of course, has different mediums, different channels, which I'd love to talk about in detail. It has different types, different kinds, but it entails anything and everything that has to do with a professional setting, be it in relation to a job you're struggling to find, or it could be a work email, it could be a new contract that you want to get, it could be a potential investor who wants to invest in your company, conversation with them, or any other stakeholder, or even for that matter, a rival, you know, or a competitor for that matter, where you have to put forward how good is your work. So I'd like to quote Burger King and McDonald's over here, because they always engage in this word war game. And it's interesting, you know, how Burger King is always very, very smart and coming up with this something very, very smart, which sounds like a joke, but is also a point towards McDonald's that we're far better than them. And Burger King has given McDonald's a very tough competition in America, not just because of the quality of product they make, but at the same time, it's all a communication game. So they're very good, very good communicators for that matter. So this is what professional communication in a nutshell is.
Yeah, and then we talk about Pakistani brands. We always see, I'm going to name some brands here, Surf Excel and what the other one called? They're always, you know, Express. They're always, you know, the nagging is like, "Hamara sasta hai," and, you know, "Hamara mahanga hai." So it's all about the brand, how you promote your brand, how you make your profile. Okay. Let's, Mariam. I would like to talk about types of personal communication, also at the places you need to be. ठीक है आपने हम बात करना चाहते हैं यहाँ पर कि जब आप एक जॉब में होते हो तो उसके कई डायनेमिक्स हैं. So how about we take it step by step? We start with startups and then we'll go towards jobs. अभी हम jobs की types कर startups की types कर लेते हैं. Startup में professional communication की कौन-कौन सी types होती हैं और क्या-क्या करना होता है. Then we'll move towards jobs. So yeah, and at the end we'll be bridging them with the difficult conversations that you might need to do at start in startup as well as in job.
Sure. So there is one big difference between a startup and working in a corporate setup. I've not mentioned small medium businesses, although that's also a job. The reason being because startups turn out to be, if they are successful, then they grow to be SMEs. So the work culture is very, it's close-knitted. It's like a family, right? So that's the main underlying difference. Otherwise, communication styles are similar across the board. There's no specific difference. But I'll come to that. So if you're talking about, would you like me to speak about startups right now?
Yes. And then we can move to a job.
All right, of course. So basically, in a startup setting and even in a general setting for that matter, there are two types of communication. One is the verbal communication. We're communicating right now. But more than that, what is perceived better and what is more important and what passes a message across the board is my non-verbal communication. I mean, is Mariam raising an eyebrow or two right now? Is she rolling her eyes? Mariam's posture, body language, so on and so forth. And they make a lot of difference, Rabe. And I'd like to start with the point of walking in into a room where you feel like, you know, you want to join a startup and you want to have a conversation with the person. You know, a lot of times when you're about to talk about something where we have to negotiate, or which I'll also come to later, probably down the road. And when we are about to have a difficult conversation, especially a conversation which involves trying to get a new job role, right? We're always hesitant. And there's a human instinct. It's also an animal instinct, a fight or flight response. You know, people get bumped, sweaty hands, jiggly legs. The same stage fight when we had, which we had when we were probably in school or college, going up on stage for debate, the initial few seconds, right? So people need to understand that this can actually be dealt with. And there's a very simple way of dealing with this. So there are actually some practices or exercises that they need to do, which requires stretching of arms, just like this. You know, if you stretch your arms, you can actually go to the restroom, stretch your arms for a bit, muscles for a bit, loosen up a little bit. Unconsciously, you will not realize your communication will be a lot better. You will be very relaxed for that matter. This is, you know, so non-verbal communication can have a huge impact, a huge difference. We usually walk up in, when people walk up for interviews, be it startup interviews, usually startups have very different modes of hiring. It's sometimes it's informal, those that, you know, come join my company, you know, we're going to just doing this and I think you're great at this.
Yeah, start thing, yeah.
Absolutely. But the many startups who grow up to be at a certain place, like there's some Pakistani seasoned startups, they actually have a proper process of hiring, like in any other company for that matter. And
same thing.
So, you know, a lot of people on the other end, jo aapko interview karein, they have a poker face. They don't have any expressions, right? तो ये एक नॉन वर्बल क्यू है जो आपको कंफ्यूज कर रहा है आर दे गोइंग टू टेक मी और आर दे नॉट गोइंग टू टेक मी सो मेंटेनिंग योर कूल एंड योर काम इज समथिंग एक्सट्रीमली एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट एट दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम सो एज या सो यू नो एंड ओपरा विनफ्री इज अ वेरी वेरी फेमस मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर शी इज एन ऑथर शी हैज ऑथर्ड सो मेनी बुक्स I think she is a savior for so many lives in the sense that, you know, she really lifts people up in their spirits. She's that woman.
Yeah.
And, you know, she practices the power pose. And what is a power pose? There are two kind of power poses. Men usually practice that in their offices. And women tend to slouch when they do. And they shouldn't, right? And I'm going to do that over here right now. You put your hands behind yourself, right? This is actually a power pose. I'm not saying that this should be practiced. That's how somebody.
I've seen people do. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
That's when the other gender is unconsciously telling you who's in charge here, right? So.
Who's the boss here?
Who's the boss? It's a very unconscious practice. So, women also, you'll also get to see a lot of people who try to shrug their shoulders or, you know, try to bend down or slouch. So it gives off a message that you're not very confident, be it an interview, be it a meeting, be it anywhere where you have to present, you have to talk. So nonverbal cues make up more than 90% of the communication. I mean, if I enter the room with my proper gait and my volume is not very mellow, it's not very soft, even if my voice is soft, but I try to maintain. And this is actually a practice of with your vocal cords. And I think anybody and everybody for that matter can actually practice, you know, their speaking skills, their speaking pitch or volume for that matter. So yeah, that can be worked upon as well. So nonverbal cues is something you can actually work upon. Women should not slouch. Even men, I've seen men not slouch for that matter. Wear colors that you feel very, very comfortable in. If you're talking about really like going out, you know, to get your job, secure your job, be it in a startup, because, and over here, I'd like to give the example of a seasoned startup because they would really go with the formal, you know, interview. And the other form of communication.
So basically, if someone, you know, wants to, if they feel really comfortable in wearing, you know, orange. I'm taking like orange. They're like really a happy person and they love wearing orange. Should they wear orange? Isn't it like weird to wear a non-work cloth color?
Thank you for asking me that question. The problem is we need to understand two things over here. Where are you applying?
Mm-hmm.
Is it, are you applying to, what is the kind of work environment that organization has? The last company I worked with, yeah, wearing trousers was a complete no-no because the work environment was very casual. Everybody was supposed to be dressed in semi-casually or casually. So I used to wear jeans to my work. And I could not imagine wearing jeans to my work in my two jobs before that because everything was very formal. So it depends on the work environment. So as somebody who's applying to a job, you need to understand what is the work environment of the company. And a good reflection of that can be perceived from the company's website, from the company's adverts, if the company is very big. Like, for example, Telenor. I'd like to quote Telenor here. Telenor has a very homely culture. I mean, it's a corporate, but it's very homely, you know. Google is very, very casual, very homely. They don't care what shirt
they're
wearing.
They're known for it. Yeah.
Not care. They only are concerned about your work. But Microsoft, you'll be surprised. Microsoft is very concerned about it. In fact, if I actually had the opportunity to visit their Seattle office, everything, all the floor was gray. It was gray carpeted. And I was like, is this really Microsoft? But yeah, it is Microsoft. That's a work culture completely different from Google, right? So every organization has their own work culture and their own work ethics. But if orange makes you happy and if you feel that the company is very casual about it, wear orange. Mm-hmm. I mean, I love yellow. I can wear yellow any day and every day to my workplace. Yeah.
Okay. Actually same. Anyways, so thank you Maryam for being so matlab itne acche se explain kiya hai ki matlab kis tarah se aapne non verbal cues ko apne dhyan mein rakhne. Acha isme ek aur example aati hai, balki hum bachpan mein kehte the ki apne kabhi speech karne jana hai to usse pehle apne sheeshe ke andar अपना बॉडी पोस्चर, आपके हाथ किस तरह से हिल रहे हैं वो बोलते बोलते देख लेना है. तो मैनी पीपल एक्चुअली डू प्रेफर यूज दिस व्हेन दे आर गोइंग फॉर इंटरव्यूज, वो टीवी के शीशे के सामने खड़े होकर इंटरव्यूज ले रहे होते हैं. आई गेस ये भी एक अच्छी प्रैक्टिस है. व्हाट डू यू से अबाउट दिस?
एब्सोल्युटली. जितनी ज्यादा आपकी, सो वन ऑफ द बेस्ट ऑरेटर्स इन द वर्ल्ड, जो सबसे अच्छे ऑरेटर्स हैं, वो यू नो, वो महीनों महीनों तक प्रैक्टिस करते थे. अब्राहम लिंकन का नाम काफी लोगों ने सुना होगा. उनका एक एड्रेस बहुत फेमस था. ही वाज वन ऑफ द प्रेसिडेंट्स ऑफ द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स, वन ऑफ द फाउंडिंग पीपल ऑफ द कंट्री. उनका एड्रेस था गेटिसबर्ग के ऊपर. एंड वो दुनिया की या शायद उनकी तारीख की सबसे छोटी, इट वाज द शॉर्टेस्ट एड्रेस टू द पब्लिक. इट वाज ओनली फॉर 4 मिनट्स. इट कवर्ड एवरीथिंग. ही ओनली टुक 4 मिनट्स. But he wrote that and he practiced that for more than a month. So, I mean, practice makes you perfect, right? I know we live in an age and in a time where we might not have that much of a time, but we definitely do have time that, you know, we can at least revise the points quickly before jumping into a meeting, for that matter, if you're saying something very important. And also like brainstorming, jotting down the points and doing all the essential homework, because even when we are saying something in our meetings, we have to be very careful that it has to be backed by evidence. And when evidence is asked for, you should have all the resources and the sources rightly quoted. So as long as you do your homework right, as long as you have the right pronunciation of words, because that also makes and creates an impact to quite an extent. Make sure when you revise or rehearse something unconsciously, you're telling yourself that you have a command over it. And once you have a command over something, you are less likely to have jiggly legs and to lose focus or to be underconfident, for that matter.
Thank you. Thank you. This was an amazing advice, Maryam. Achha, let's we talked about startups and वहां से लिया, लेकिन हमने बीच में ऐसी भी आपकी अपने ऐसी भी बातें की जो कि जॉब से भी बहुत रेलिवेंट है. Now let's just jump into jobs, because professional jobs जो मतलब most लोग professional jobs करते हैं, कुछ startups होते हैं if you go into the bigger percentage. तो उसमें अब professional communication में आपकी when I imagine कि ये इसके types होते हैं. You do presentation skills, आप subordinate और अपने इस बड़े से और अपने छोटे से बात कर रहे होते हैं, जो level में ऊपर नीचे होते हैं उनसे बात कर रहे होते हैं, and then you have your emails. So let's start with, I guess let's just start with the email. जब आप किसी job के लिए apply कर रहे होते हो, तब email भेज रहे होते हो, आप acceptance letter का thank you note भेज रहे होते हो, आप email लिख रहे होते हो. तो ये जो form of communication है, इसके लिए आपके पास best tips and tricks क्या है?
ठीक है, राबेल, विद योर परमिशन, कैन आई ऑल्सो टच बेस ऑन द फोर मेन स्टाइल्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन व्हिच आर वर्बल, व्हिच आर नॉट नॉन वर्बल?
Yeah,
and then I'll take your question. I'll go through them very quickly. So in any organization or even in any startup, you'll find four types of cartoons, four types of people, right? One will be somebody who is giving you instructions, do this, do that, and is processing information very quickly, will hold you accountable, and you might find that person insensitive, although that person is not insensitive. That person is trying to save time and do as many tasks as possible. This kind of a communication style is known as that of director, right? So they call as director. I mean, it could be anyone. You don't have to be a certain person. Everybody has a different style. So, and then you have another type of, category of people of how they express themselves or communicate in organizations. They're known as thinkers. You give them a piece of information, they'll think a lot about it, you know, to the extent that they end up procrastinating, they end up wasting time. Although they're jotting down points, but, you know, they take a lot of time. They're like, everything has to be perfect. And whatever information you give them, I mean, they're also very good listeners for that matter. Then you also happen to have expressive. So expressives are very interesting because not only are they absorbing information, but at the same time, they're also expressing themselves. Whatever thought comes into their minds, and, you know, simultaneously they'll speak the mind and heart out. And harmonizers are the ones that actually not only take in information, but also, you know, they speak when they consider that the time is right. And they keep a check between facts and figures and what needs to be done and not done in the company. So the four types of communication styles, and it can be easily, information can be easily found on the internet if anybody needs more detail about this. Basically, personality type depend karta hai. What kind of a person are you? It reflects in your communication style, right? And coming to professional emails, how should we respond when we're writing an email? So again, I would say that there's one thing that a lot of companies miss out on. Connecting that emotional connect, making it human. If I write, hi, you know, this, regards, this, there's no connect. There's no feel. It's like, SMS that I'll get on my phone, it's like the regular spam email that is, you know, that you're thwarted with, I might even lose interest and I'll be like, what is this? But, you know, how the different companies running different campaigns, marketing campaigns, some very interesting campaigns, and it hits hard. One of my favorite set of ads is by Docomo India. Airtel has amazing advertisement as well. And from Pakistani telcos, I love how Ufone communicates. And I know I'm referring that right now, relating that to emails, because if your email comes from your heart, when you form that emotional connect with your customer or even with your subordinate or with your boss or with your colleague for that matter, you know, there is a lot of, one, the level of trust increases since it's more personalized, the other person feels valued. Thirdly, it is also a reflection on the kind of relationship you want to foster. Like, you want to foster a good relation, a good working relationship with that particular person. And how do you personalize emails? You start with, hi, Maryam, I really hope you're doing well. Like, we're living in crazy COVID times. Just ask, you know, I know we're living in crazy COVID times. I hope everything is all right at your end and you're managing your work really well, right? So that just created that connect. I care about the person, yeah. I care about the work, and then I ask them for whatever I need from them, right? Would you mind to know this yeah. person? Would you be happy to connect me with this person? Or probably my,
And Maryam, that and then when you write all this, the reply you're going to get is not going to be like, hi, yes, this was done, regards this. This will be, hi, I hope you're doing it good as well. I'm good. Everything is good at my end. And, you know, it's, you're going to just build a connection with the person, right? And a relationship, a good relationship.
Absolutely. A chord, I mean, Kareem adds, why do they hit a chord? Uber ki kyun nahi karte? I mean, let's talk about it, right? Mm-hmm. It's all about communication.
But exactly, I was just agreeing with you that Kareem jo hai wo personalized ads bheja raha hai. Barish ho rahi hai, so they'll, you know, send up aapke phone page upar aa jayega ki barish ho rahi hai, dhyan rakhe. Matlab they're very concerned about their customers. Aur is tarah se aapne agar beshak अगर आप सोच रहे हो कि अब मैं उबर करा लेता हूँ, क्रीम का एक पर्सनलाइज मैसेज देखोगे, आप खुद ही सोचोगे ये क्रीम भी हो सकती है. मतलब सो दे कैप्चर देयर ऑडियंस लाइक दैट,
या एब्सोल्युटली,
थ्रू देयर परफेक्ट कम्युनिकेशन.
एब्सोल्युटली. सो दिस इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट मैटर्स. सो ईमेल्स नीड टू बी पर्सनलाइज्ड. आई वुडंट टॉक मोर ऑन द फॉर्मेट बिकॉज एवरी कंपनी हैज अ डिफरेंट फॉर्मेट. सम कंपनीज एक्चुअली रिक्वेस्ट फॉर समथिंग वेरी वेरी strictly worded in a very professional sense. Now, for example, if a company is applying for a grant, of course it has to be like a formal worded document. But if you are talking to a potential investor, or you you know, you want to call somebody to a networking opportunity, or you want to connect for business reasons, let it be very personalized, you know. And also, when you're writing down emails and when you're connecting with someone who happens to be a potential client, please do the homework. It is so important. It will be amazing if I mention, for example, if I want to partner with Ufone, with a Ufone, and I and in my CV, in my email, I mentioned that, you know, I absolutely love the dash campaign of Ufone that was done, you know, last year. And it helped me with this and this, you know, and I really look forward that I actually help your team carry out such further operations whatsoever. So, I mean, it actually gives the company or your potential client an idea that, oh, they already have done their homework and they already know what they're talking about and what they want to do. It also offers that level of clarity, you know. So, yeah, that's great.
And in that, and I just, so आपने अभी अपनी ईमेल रीड आउट की कि व्हाट वुड यू राइट टू यू फोन, ठीक है. तो इसमें मैंने एक बहुत अच्छी बात पिक की जो कि कल गजनफर बात कर रहे थे कि आपने भी ईमेल की बात की. व्हाट यू मेंशन वाज कि आई विल बी ऑफ ग्रेट हेल्प टू यू इन डूइंग दिस. सो व्हेन वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट पर्सनल ब्रांडिंग, प्रोफाइल ब्रांडिंग और पर्सनल ब्रांडिंग के बारे में बात करें, तो बेसिकली व्हाट यू डिड वाज कि इंस्टेड ऑफ यू फोन को आपकी जरूरत पड़े, मतलब सॉरी इंस्टेड आपको यूफोन की जरूरत है बल्कि यूफोन को आपकी जरूरत है. यूफोन वुड थिंक कि यार ये बंदा बड़ा रिसोर्सफुल है, ही इज गोना डू ग्रेट एट आवर कंपनी, सो वी शुड टेक हिम. सो इन दैट ईमेल आपने ये बड़ी अच्छी बात कवर कर दी. सो आई रियली लाइक दैट,
थैंक यू. व्हाट इन्फ्लुएंसर्स डू, जस्ट लाइक एन एंडिंग नोट ओवर हियर फॉर दिस स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन. इन्फ्लुएंसर्स, it's a game of communication. They build that communication, they build that connect. They're different influences for different things. Koi fashion ka hoga, koi lifestyle ka hoga. We have so many Pakistani influences working on lifestyle. Wo apni personal lives bhi dikhate hain. Theek hai? And the audience finds a connect. And then what happens? Their products of so many companies actually get sponsored, you know, and they actually happen to pay the influencers to talk about their products. So this is exactly how things work. Then the company will walk up to you. It's all about the right communication.
Theek ho gaya. So we talked about emails over here. Acha, let's talk about presentation skills, but वो वाली प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स नहीं कि जो मतलब बच्चों को तो हमें अब यूनिवर्सिटी जो गोइंग होता है उसको तो प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स देयर अनदर टिप बिकॉज़ वो एक आपकी करिकुलम के अंदर होती हैं. बट हाउ आर टेल मी अबाउट हाउ कि एक जॉब के दौरान प्रेजेंटेशन डिफरेंट होती है फ्रॉम योर स्कूल प्रेजेंटेशन, और इज देयर अ डिफरेंस और देयर इज नो डिफरेंस, उसमें कोई डिफरेंस है या नहीं है?
आई थिंक नंबर वन, आई थिंक देयर इज नो स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मूला टू प्रेजेंटेशन. आई डोंट बिलीव इन दैट. What we are taught in schools is very elementary, very basic. It's all about communication and how you want to do it. I mean, if I want to start my presentation when I'm asked to present, I will, because that usually happens in meetings. Your client can ask you for a presentation or not ask you for a presentation. That is, you could either use it to show what kind of work you will do for them, or they just want you to talk. But the best form of communication or even presentation is that without using any technical terms, you explain what are you doing. And that is your success. And I think that should be taught in schools, in colleges, in universities, and should be practiced. I would frankly lose interest if I start my presentation with a PowerPoint, with bullets and so many points. I think I would be done by the second slide. But if there is a presentation where there's a fancy ninja and there's a GIF of a ninja, you know, doing like this pose, right? My presentation is about, for example, my presentation is about how to bring businesses online. But I create a very fancy title. I create a title like Watermelons, Stardust, and Business Skills. Now that would actually capture interest, right? So start your presentation by surprising your audience. This is one of the tips that I'll give. Secondly, it should be so simply worded, so simply phrases that even your grandmother understands what you're trying to tell. That will be your success.
Achha. हालांकि ऑन द कॉन्ट्री व्हाट वी आर टॉट इन स्कूल, और मतलब बिल्कुल वो तो हम तो भी वर्डेड होती है प्रेजेंटेशन में आपके मटेरियल होना चाहिए. बट व्हाट आई एम हियरिंग फ्रॉम यू इज द एडवाइस दैट यू आर गिविंग हियर इज के प्रेजेंटेशन में मटेरियल होना चाहिए, बट द वे यू आर वर्डिंग योर मटेरियल शुड बी अंडरस्टैंडेबल टू पीपल, लाइक इट्स अ स्टोरी. Like you're telling someone a story कि एक दफा का वाकया है, and वो बंदा जो सुन रहा है, instead of आप एक वो lecture सुन रहे हो, जो मतलब एक literally जो word lecture है कि भाई ऐसे 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 ऐसे.
Challenge, but I think it can be overcome with the passage of time. You just have to be yourself. That is another very important presentation tip. Please be yourself. I mean. Was me what I just did. I actually I was presenting to the National Incubation Center, the startups go to market strategy, and it had the dab in the very first slide, you know, and everybody was like, oh, and then all the startups, you know, jaag gaye the. So yeah, it has to be connect with your audience, and connect with your audience ki baat hai, if that's a room full of uncles, and for example, they have an interest in something which relates to poetry. And I'm sure agar baby boomers jo hain, they're all very familiar with Iqbal. So agar aap wahan se kuch quote karke suna, you can connect with our audience. So it's very important to connect with your audience.
Thank you, Maryam. It was very insightful. Achha, let's move from, we talked about emails, we talked about presentation skills. Ab aa jate hain hum, आपने किसी वहाँ पर आपने इस चीज़ का ध्यान रखना कि आप ईमेल या आप नॉर्मल कन्वर्सेशन. अच्छा, लेट्स जस्ट गो टुवर्ड्स डिफिकल्ट कन्वर्सेशन. लेट्स जस्ट मूव ऑन देम, क्योंकि बहुत सारी एग्जांपल मेरे दिमाग में आ रही है वो डिफिकल्ट कन्वर्सेशन के ही रिलेटेड हो रही हैं. मैं इंटरव्यू में बैठी हुई हूँ, एंड मुझे उन्होंने कहा है कि आपकी इतनी पे हो, और वो पे जो है वो उतनी नहीं हो रही जितनी मैं चाहती हूँ कि हो, वो थोड़ी है. मैं तो मतलब मैं पिछली जॉब पे इससे भी ज़्यादा कमा रही थी, नाउ ये उससे कम है. तो हाउ डू आई आस्क फॉर अ पे रेज, एंड इसी बात को लेके आप मुझे बताएं कि आपने काम किया 2-3 साल एंड नाउ यू वांट अ पे रेज, एंड आपका बहुत दोस्त है, आपका जो सीनियर है वो आपके दोस्त है, हाउ डू यू टॉक? एंड देन एक बंदा है जो कि आपका बनती नहीं है उससे, हाउ डू यू टॉक टू देम? तो इसके हमें जरा बता दें कि किस तरह कम्युनिकेट करना है.
Absolutely. ये तो बहुत important point है, and I think that's a weakness. हम लोग तकल्लुफ नहीं मांगते, and then we suffer. And किसी को नुकसान नहीं होता, except for our own selves. I would like to start with, this is the art of negotiation. And इसके लिए दो तीन key phrases हैं या terms हैं जो मैं यहाँ पे, if anybody would like to take notes, they can. I'd like to teach them. The very first thing you need to ask, even if somebody is asking you, you know, आपको जैसे for example the session, ठीक है, you should ask, is it a paid gig? I have the right to ask if somebody is asking me to be a speaker.
ठीक
है, I can casually put forward, is this a paid gig? Question mark. पहली बात तो ये, अगर आपको कोई बुलाए बोलने के लिए कहीं तो आप ये पूछ सकते हैं, वो बताएंगे no, yes. अगर आपको पता है कि वो एक स्टार्टअप है, वो काम शुरू कर रहे हैं, you wouldn't even ask, right? But अगर आपको पता है कि वो जो है they are a proper company, राइट, तो फिर आप एक्सपेक्ट करें कि वो आपको ऑनेरियम दें एट लीस्ट. यस, ऑनेरियम इज बेसिकली के जैसे आपकी सर्विसेज के लिए इट्स लाइक अ थैंक यू, थोड़ा अमाउंट होता है, इट्स नॉट अ बिग अमाउंट. तो उसको पे मैं नहीं कहूंगी, उसको ऑनेरियम की कैटेगरी में डालूंगी. आई वुड लाइक टू कोट अवे हियर, अ वेरी बिग एंड वेरी रिप्यूटेबल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रीच्ड आउट टू मी एंड टू रन वन ऑफ देयर स्टार्टअप प्रोग्राम्स. I can name them, but I don't want to. I was very, very blunt with them because they were giving me peanuts for asking me to do multiple sessions, 9 to 5. I mean, I'm taking out time from my commitments. I'm giving them time, giving them. When I asked them how much to, kitne itna, maine kaha, are you serious? Maine kaha, aap galti se bhi kisi ko quote na kare. Because it reflects very poorly on your organization, which is such a big institute, has been functional for so long. Like, where's your money going? They didn't have an answer to that. Secondly, when we don't want something, and for example, somebody is giving me 35K, but I know that I deserve 50K, just a hypothetical example. So I very easily quote that, अगर वो आपसे पूछते हैं हाउ मच ऑफ सैलरी आर यू एक्सपेक्टिंग, इट्स ऑलवेज बेटर टू कोट अ हायर रेट, लाइक यू नो 60K, बिकॉज यू नो इट्स लाइक अ ट्रेंड, दे लाइक दे वुड कम डाउन एंड यू नो दे विल बी लाइक अ मिडिल पॉइंट दैट यू बोथ विल बोथ द पार्टीज विल मीट इवेंचुअली. और इवन इन अदर केस इट कुड बी यू कुड बी वेरी वेरी ऑनेस्ट दैट यू नो आई वाज बीइंग ऑफर्ड दिस मच एंड माय मार्केट आई अंडरस्टैंड माय मार्केट वैल्यू एंड आई वुड लाइक टू वर्क फॉर एट लीस्ट दिस मच. You know, I actually negotiated for my very first job. I mean, I initially wanted to get experience of the work industry before I stepped in the entrepreneurial space. So I remember I was a fresh graduate. I did not apply. I was offered a job, and this is back in 2012, ages back, 9 years back. But I negotiated. I think उस जमाने में I started off at a very good position. I was manager marketing and industrial linkages for a private university, and I started with 50K, which is not at all bad for 2012, because I evaluated my level, what everybody else was doing in the market. I said either it's this or I'm not working. I actually said that. I mean, I could have come under the pressure, नहीं चली जाएगी, but I did not. So you also have to stand your ground. If you know you're good enough, just, you know, don't settle for less. Negotiate.
Say. Good. अच्छा मैं यहीं पे आपसे क्वेश्चन करूंगी, वाज इट इन एन इंटरव्यू, वाज इट इन एन ईमेल, या फिर अच्छा ये भी होता है ना, फॉर एग्जांपल यू वर इन एन इंटरव्यू एंड आपने उस वक्त मान लिया कि वर्बली कि इतनी पे होगी, बट देन यू थिंक अबाउट इट एंड यू रियलाइज कि इतनी पे नहीं है, एंड ऑल्सो यू थिंक कि यार यही जॉब है. So then what do you write an email or do you meet them personally, or uska agar wo situation mein banda ho jaye to banda tab kya kare?
Okay, so do not say yes to something you're not sure about. So always, as a rule, never say yes or no immediately. Always say thank you so much for the opportunity, I'd like to think about it and I'll get back to you. अगर वो आपको ये कह रहे हैं आप उनको ये कह सकते हैं बिकॉज बोथ पार्टीज आर इन्वॉल्व. Okay, thank you so much for the opportunity. I really appreciate it. I'd like to take a day or two to think about it and I'll let you know. Okay? And then uske baad aapne no ya yes nahi kaha apni salary pe, you can always you know, get back to them, revert back by email.
Reverse back.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, yeah.
Theek ho gaya. ठीक हो गया. ग्रेट. सो वी टॉक्ड अबाउट के भाई पेरियस को आपने बढ़वाना कैसे करने. अच्छा लेट्स टॉक अबाउट आप एक आपके एक सीनियर हैं एंड उन्होंने आपको एक टास्क दिया और वो आए हैं इन्हीं उनका जो आपने स्टाइल्स मेंशन किए ना उसमें उनका डायरेक्टर वाला स्टाइल था. ही जस्ट केम ही वाज लाइक आई वांट टू डू दिस आई वांट टू डू दिस आई वांट टू डू दैट एंड ही जस्ट वेंट ही जस्ट वेंट एंड Now you're thinking, अच्छा जिसमें भी दो सिनेरियो थे कि शाम बिल्कुल 5 बजे काम के चले गए और आप कहें आप मुझे ईमेल कर दीजिएगा कल काम है आपने करना है एंड नाउ यूर थिंकिंग कि भाई मुझे तो बात समझ नहीं आई है तो एंड ही वो डायरेक्टर स्टाइल भी है उनका तो हाउ डू यू अप्रोच योर सीनियर इन दैट पोजिशन. आपने किस तरह से उन्हें अप्रोच किया.
अगर वो किसी को नहीं सुन रहे कम्युनिकेशन लैक इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड दैट्स अ प्रॉब्लम. When I say director, it's not like they don't listen, but they'll be very blunt. Mm-hmm. For example, if I say something and if it's not right, because there are her company ke standard operating procedures hote hain jo define karte hain what is right and what is wrong. According to that, if it isn't right, he'll be very ruthlessly blunt. Ke Mariam, this isn't right. I'm sorry. This I'm not going to buy that. And if my opinion of what I'm putting forward is great and in sync with the SOP, he'll be like, yeah, let's go ahead with it. So it's always good to reach out by emails. Some companies, for that matter, have their or departments have their own WhatsApp groups where people can plug in information and ask each other, ask colleagues, or refer to a colleague if you are new in an organization. But it's the best to when you're having a conversation with your colleague or your boss, for that matter, it's always good to ask immediately. Clarification is the key. But if they're not willing to listen, then that's a communication lapse, then that's a problem in the organization, and that can cause delay in things getting done, not just with this concerned person, but also with other people, which is not a good practice.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. 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 Because I'm a student too, and I really want to know the HR department. रिलेशंस का डिपार्टमेंट है दे टॉक अबाउट कम्युनिकेशन डील करते हैं वो टेल अस हाउ दैट वर्क्स एंड इफ यू आर न्यू इन अ कंपनी और आप बिल्कुल एक नए बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट में आ रहे हैं यू आर स्टेपिंग अप तो आप एचआर को बेहतरीन तरीके से डिपार्टमेंट को कैसे यूज कर सकते हैं.
सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज एचआर से ज्यादा है आपकी नेटवर्क. स्टेटमेंट बट योर नेटवर्क इज योर नेटवर्क.
अच्छा
without applying I have been offered jobs almost all my life. Even after starting Impact Dynamics I was actually offered 2 positions at Google, a big position when Alibaba was coming to Pakistan, a lot of money, and I refused that. And the reason is because your network has to be so strong and also your hard work. I mean people actually through that network they actually get to see your work. जैसे कि मैंने आपको बताया आई वॉज ऑफर्ड माई फर्स्ट जॉब आई डिड नॉट अप्लाई फॉर दैट एंड बिफोर दैट आई वॉज अ स्टूडेंट बट एज अ स्टूडेंट आई वॉज सच एन एक्टिव स्टूडेंट दैट आई डिड दीज कॉन्फ्रेंसेज आई कनेक्टेड विद पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री इट रियली डज क्रिएट एन इम्पैक्ट. सो एचआर यूजुअली रेफर्स टू वर्ड्स रेफरल्स फर्स्ट एंड आई वुड लाइक टू पुट इट ओवर हियर इट्स वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सिफारिश. Sifarish is when somebody is not worthy of something and they're given that seat. Referral is if somebody thinks you're good or if somebody tells you this is a good seat, why don't you take a look at it? And then you interview the person. And the person falls up to the criteria, you hire the person. Referrals work in any and every organization, even these big tech companies like Facebook and Google. They actually, Google has a form on the site that, you know, where employers can actually refer someone, you know, who they think is the right person for the job. So it works throughout the world.
You say.
HR is very different, again, for every company. Some companies have a very conventional model. Some interviews are very informal. Some interviews are very formal, but depending on the work environment, again. Some companies have a very, in order to remove bias, they ask multiple employees to actually interview, you know, the person they're going to hire. It's not just the HR department. The HR department, it's very interesting, you know. Google does that. Teen interviews hote hain, bias ko eliminate karne ke liye, aur uske baad, if you're good, you get selected. So that is how the HR department works. You have to do the job hunting. Over here, I'd like to put forward, please, please, please focus on your LinkedIn profile. Nobody's going to, you know, nobody has the time to actually know who Maryam Arshad is. Unless Maryam doesn't put it out herself over out there, nobody would be interested in hiring Maryam. So she has to do it herself. And that goes for anyone and everyone. Yeah.
Thank you. Another amazing advice. Acha, Maryam, we talked about all of these things right now. Acha, ab, let's talk further. Acha, hamara ek pura session hai workplace harassment ke upar and talking what consent is. You're in a workplace and aapke saath kuch hota hai aur dusri example bhi main yahan karungi aapke colleague I don't know, maybe. अच्छा आपके साथ ही होता है ठीक है एंड हाउ डू यू गो अबाउट इट एंड हमारे पाकिस्तान में प्रोसीजर्स क्या हैं आई एम श्योर डिफरेंट जो वर्क प्लेसेज हैं उनके डिफरेंट होंगे बट इट इज़ समथिंग जो कि आजकल एक टॉपिक भी है और इस पर काम हो रहा है एंड एक्चुअली लोग सुन रहे हैं इस बारे में तो आई रियली वांट टू टॉक अबाउट दिस कि इसकी कन्वर्सेशन को किस तरह से बंदा कर सकता है अपनी कंपनी
I mean, I'd like to start with mentioning that workplace harassment, the laws of on workplace harassment, and you can always report. If even if your company you feel is not following the rules, you can always report that. Whistleblowing ki log baat karte hain honi chahiye ki nahi honi chahiye, which is ki agar kuch galat ho raha hai company mein aap bataein. I think aapko batana chahiye. Jahan pe betterment hai aapki company ki aur logon ki. Having said that. I strongly believe that people should not hesitate from coming up and because women tend to be shy because you know it puts gives them a bad name there've been some harassment cases unfortunately jahan pe I mean mostly women are harassed but in very rare instances men are also harassed and they feel they feel worse like they don't talk about it but in any case we do have laws so our company actually did a research and we found out the research was on making workplaces more human and we found out that banks apparently are have the best harassment rules and laws and they're very strict about that.
Achha.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Personally, I feel that even if somebody is trying to harass you, you should always, always report. You can report online. Then we know women who are working around this. There's Nikit Dad. She also runs like a digital rights foundation for women. There are other women. So you can always report if you feel like you're being shy. There are actually groups where you can you know you can connect with. But I am sure that the organization always lends support. You should always refer. Your own organization first because I mean agar aapne unko nahi bataya you cannot hold them accountable then that will be wrong report to your HR immediately file a complaint tell them what has happened and do not be scared about anything because if somebody is wrong they need to be held accountable it's not about if you haven't done anything wrong you will not also not be losing your job so you do not have to be worried about that and I mean even in the startup ecosystem there've been cases there was this very famous music company Patari where the female staff of that company actually filed you know against the CEO had to step down you know it was all public it was all over the news it was all over social media Mm-hmm. So if something wrong, you report. Simple. If the HR is not listening, if the HR is not listening, then you refer to the Digital Rights Foundation and the other organizations that can help women out and even men for that matter. But the HR should be able to help. Agar wo nahi kare, phir aap please aage case ko pursue karein. Don't be quiet about it.
Case ko pursue karein.
Absolutely.
अच्छा I think we have talked about all of the big issues of personal communication. हमने major topics discuss कर लिए हैं. We are now at the end of our live session. Maryam, I would just like you to conclude what we have talked about today, or maybe if you have any other pointers you would like to put out there for our audience, you're most welcome to.
Okay, all right. I would like to answer one question which is in the chat box. Visha asked this question, and she's like, she's talking about the influencers on Instagram. Visha, it's not necessary to be an Insta influencer. If you have your heart in being an influencer, you want to talk about one thing, just like YouTube influencers, you don't have to talk about anything at all. You're not an influencer then. If you talk about your field, your line of work, or your hobby, for example, I love Vespa. If my feed is filled with Vespa stories, my travel stories, people who have a similar interest will start following me. And if I am really good at my game, I will be trending, right? So that's how, you know, it actually, that's how you start becoming an influencer. If you talk about anything and everything, you're not really an influencer. And trust me, it's not even the number of likes, which likes can be bought these days. So it's not even about the number of likes. It's about the kind of engagement and the kind of content you're putting forward. Yeah, absolutely. Like in, locally in my industry in Peshawar, I consider myself like on a low scale, a small business development influencer, because my Insta is about it's my personal blog. I made a post about Retinama in the morning. It was a story, and then about my film lab a couple of weeks back, and in between about COVID and how I'm spending my time, right? So that's that. You don't have to be an influencer if you don't want to be.
Thank you, Maryam. I hope Visha ko apna answer mil gaya ho, and I hope she learned something from it. Thank you so much, Maryam, for coming live with us, talking to us about personal communication. Aur aapne itne sare avenues uske aapne discuss kiye. Achan, we have another question. I'm not gonna let you go right now. So Visha asks again. So it's Varda. She asks, how to communicate with a person who is a bit exploding, clever, or makes you feel guilty?
Okay. If they're right, you know, in your heart, they're right. But if they're playing mind games with you, you don't have to give in for a start. I mean, it's very easy to say. But if the person has no direct effect on your work, I still maintain your business. Give that non-verbal cue that I'm not interested in talking to you. Back off. You don't have to
say.
You do not always have to use words to explain that I don't want to keep up with you. On the face, you can be very cordial. Now, if that person is, of course, in a professional setting, you have to be courteous, because that reflects on you and that reflects on your level of professionalism. But then after that, you don't have to share your meal, be together in the lunch break, do that awe moment, or be nice or get with them. You don't have to. And if you feel like, you know, they're trying to exploit you, like if they're trying to bully you, that is also workplace harassment, by the way. Bullying is another form of harassment, or that's not right. Non-verbally change your cues. Make sure your pitch is strong, you're loud, your voice, your body tone. Practice the power postures, make sure your back is straight. It actually unconsciously has a huge impact. You might not realize it, but it does. And avoid the person, not by getting scared, like in the sense, not giving them a feel that you avoid them because you're getting scared, but because you're not interested. Simple. Yeah. The sky wouldn't fall down.
So,
if they're not going to change, you know, if they're not responsible for your promotion, who cares? It's not the end of the world.
Okay, so what if they are responsible for my promotion? What do you do then? You can't avoid them, and also you cannot even give them a cold shoulder. बट नाउ नाउ यूर नाउ अब क्या करें
अगर वो आपको एक्सप्लॉइट कर रहे हैं, बिकॉज द टर्म एक्सप्लॉइट इज नॉट यूज्ड इन अ गुड लाइट. आई मीन इफ दे आर ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लॉइट यू, यू फाइल अ कंप्लेंट टू द एचआर. दैट कुड लीड टू टू थिंग्स. And a lot of people might disagree with me that, oh, this is not how things work in Pakistan. But if there are many people who file complaints, this is exactly how things work in Pakistan. This is exactly what happened at Pattari. This is exactly how the CEO stepped down, CEO of the company stepped down. So, I mean, you have to be very strong like that. And then you should have, it's also always good to have like proof and evidence. Make sure you have your backup of proofs. And frankly speaking, where you're not respected, that's not the right place to be at. So move on. Yeah. But
thank you, Maryam. That was make sure you give the signal. Okay. And you tell them to pay bus. Ab nahi. No more. Thank you so much, Maryam, for joining us. You stayed with us for time hamara halaki 45 minutes hota hai. You stayed with us for 10 more minutes. Thank you so much for engaging with us, for taking our audience in, aur aapne bahut achhe se jo hai wo hume explain kiya ki personal communication kaise hoti hai. Humne startups se baat ki, jobs se baat ki, SMEs ko bhi thoda sa touch kiya humne yahan par. And so thank you so much. Thank you so much, our viewers, everyone who watched us, and jinhone comments kiye, likes kiye, shares kiye. Thank you so much, guys, for engaging with us. Tomorrow we'll see you again at 7:30 p.m. with a new interesting topic, with a new speaker, an expert on it. Allah Hafiz. Apna khyal rakhiyega, apne ghar walon ko khyal rakhiyega. Stay safe, stay home. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.